We know when we give in to our selfishness, our cowardice, our laziness, our compulsiveness, and we know God has granted us the power to hold back from that compulsiveness, from that laziness, from that fearfulness, from that temptation. Unless and until somehow we regulate our life and we properly use God-given powers, we do not feel quite ready to be admitted in divine chamber, where the divine treasures are available. So we have to prove our worth by self-discipline, by sharing whatever we are capable of sharing with our fellow beings, and by remembering whatever we believe is worth remembering most of the time. There is no need to remember all the time about car, about job, about ice cream, about a movie, about anything. What we should remember is our ultimate goal. An ultimate goal is God realization, who has given us this human birth. I requested you the first day, and I am reminding you because it is our last day during my this trip. Make sure every morning to devote 2 minutes for God or for your ultimate freedom, liberation, blissfulness. And I want you to remember how I want you to spend those 2 minutes. In first 1 minute, thank God. Whatever you think is going on good in your life. If you do not find anything great in your life, thank God for giving you a human life, giving you beautiful eyes, beautiful ears, beautiful hands, beautiful loving heart, beautiful tongue, that you can taste so many delicacies. Whatever you can think in that moment that you can be grateful to, be grateful to God. The subtle point is when you open your heart from the point of view of gratitude, from the point of view of thanking God, it is like you open a special channel, a special window, and through that window, God's grace, God's love, God's light start pouring in to your heart. That is for 1 minute, only for 1 minute. Express your gratitude to God in whatever you think you can express your gratitude or appreciation for God. Then in next moment or in next minute, you pray to God, God grant me the power of being truthful. God grant me the power of remembering you constantly. God grant me the power of recognizing and realizing that you are the sole doer. I am simply a puppet. There are 3 things I am proposing for prayer. One is grant me the power of truthfulness so that I don't deviate from my truthfulness, the way I understand what truthfulness is. Let us not play a clever game of rationalizing, but otherwise our mind is very clever. It can always find a reason why it should be untruthful, and how everybody in the world is untruthful, how world itself is not real, so how truthfulness can be practiced in an untruthful world. Our mind is so clever that is why we need a good teacher sometimes who could reveal for us when we start being clever. A teacher is required not for bestowing any special grace on us, but only to reveal for us our mind, how our mind starts playing games of cleverness and rationalizations with itself. To the extent we trust a person, a friend or a teacher, we know that he or she is not interested for his or her own selfish reason when he or she is telling us that we are just rationalizing and we are just being clever. It is like you look into the mirror and if you see a black spot anywhere on your face, you don't doubt the mirror. You just clean your face. Three things we have to pray. God grant me the power of truthfulness. That is one thing. Second is, God grant me the power of constant remembrance. You will remember God the way your teacher had advised you, or you have become convinced by your own experience. Whether you remember God through your breathing process, whether you remember God through your mantra, whether you remember God by being a witness, whatever way it suits you. And the third thing is, God, make me realize, to recognize this fact that you are the sole doer, I am only a puppet. Because here lies the whole huge burden. I have to raise my children. I have to get them settled. I have to make sure my children are married, they have good education, they are this and that. So much burden is constantly in our head for one reason or the other. I have to pay the bills, I have to drive the car. It is very difficult in the beginning stage to understand and realize how God Himself or Herself is living through you as you, and how God Himself or Herself is living through me as me. But this is the greatest realization in my understanding. Once you are exposed to this wisdom, that God is living through you, God is doing everything for you, of course through you, God is going to feed you with your own hand. God is going to take you from one place to another place through your own feet. God is going to help you to come to a conclusion through your own thinking process. Because God is everywhere. So God is using you for letting you reach the ultimate height. This fact has been realized by all the great mystics. Something we can understand if we read the lives of great mystics. And if we are somehow exposed to any great man or woman who lives that kind of life, then it becomes our first-hand experience that someone lives this kind of life without any fear, without any temptation, without any kind of pretension,